We are in Smart Lighting and Smart Sensing 2016 conference with Silvia Miok. She is the Director of Industrial Collaboration and Innovation of the Rensselaer Center for Lighting Enabled System and Applications. We used to know the Smart Lighting ERC Center, and now there's a change. Silvia, could you tell us what you are doing now in the center and why you changed the name?
We're taking advantage of digitized lighting to develop the lighting system that will make people healthier, more productive, and save energy at the same time. In addition to delivering the right light when and where it's needed, our systems also provide data. We're using a heterogeneous network of VLC, visible light communication, for the downlink, coupled with RF for the uplink, to address the bandwidth shortage that current systems have with the exponential growth of mobile. We've recently changed the name of the center to better articulate where we see the value of lighting systems be in the future, providing new services and enabling new applications area never possible before. Areas of expansion we see are building management system, healthcare, horticulture, and immersive environments.
Part of our intelligent lighting systems is a platform for occupancy detection and activity estimation.
This platform is very special because it preserves privacy. It can tell us how many people are in a room, what tracking them, where they're going, but not tell us who they are. So this is very important for indoor spaces. You can immediately see the relevance to building management systems. If you know how many people you have and where they are in the building, you can optimize heating and cooling to make them feel more comfortable. Healthcare, another exciting area. Of course, there's also building, so you can do all of that, what I mentioned before. We're also doing light therapy studies. We've already started on studying the effect of light on sleep and on traumatic brain injury. In addition, the privacy preserving is even more important here. For instance, such as the occupancy detection also is able to detect falls. A system like ours can be installed even in bathrooms where you can imagine that cameras will never be tolerated. Another exciting area is of immersive environments. Our goal is to optimize group interactions. There's a lot of help for individuals, Siri, Cortana, Alexa, but there's nothing for groups. So we are planning to add audio technologies for speaker recognition and emotional state estimation, and couple that with advanced computing algorithm and natural language detection to enhance productivity of groups. We envision spaces responding to the occupants and taking meeting minutes and assigning action items, et cetera. And then the fourth area of expansion is that of horticulture, where our control and sensing piece is very important. Turns out that plants biofluoresce under stress, and this is the ideal feedback signal to optimize the spectral content of the light for improved nutrient and just-in-time growth.
Silvia, one more question to wrap up. Based on your presentation yesterday, you told us about the area where you see these systems expanding the fastest. Could you tell us for our readers what would be the area?
Oh, yes. We see healthcare as being the first adoption area because that's where the return on investment argument is much easier to articulate. If you can shorten the length of stay in hospital in an intensive care unit, for instance, even by half a day, at least in the US, that translates into thousands and thousands of dollars of savings.
Thank you very much, Silvia.